everyone. I'm Neha Tyagi from IIMA Alumni Office, and we have with us Mr. Chetan Bhagat here.
Hi.
Welcome, sir.
Hi, Neha. How are you?
I'm good. So first of all, congratulations for
Thank
your
you.
Award. And I would like to ask you a few questions about it. Whether it is your books or the movies based on your books, the campus life has always been a significant part
yes.
of it. So tell us about how life at IIMA fueled your imagination.
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of my novels have some sort of a campus. My first novel, 5.1, has IIT. Revolution 2015 had a private college. But I think for IIM Ahmedabad, as far as concerned, the biggest inspiration came in two states. Either it's the book or the movie. A lot of it was set here. And it's actually the most close to my life kind of book I've written. So the entire journey of IIMA inspired me. I met my wife here, and that kind of changed my life and my kids today and everything. So I think IIMA to me was where I met somebody I married. So of course, and all the studies and everything else. So I mean, if you see the movie Two States or if you read the book Two States, that pretty much tells you. I'm also very happy, and of course the institute really cooperated. That Two States is the only movie that has been shot on Ahmedabad campus.
So how significant is it to you to follow one's passion and make bold choices as you did?
I mean, some people say I make very bold choices. I would say I make bolder choices than others, but I have not made super bold choices. So it's just the way I am. For me, I always tell people this, and now I have motivational talks also. I tell people that you live once and you should try to live the life you want to live. Why live something else, and why live under fear or pressure? And I think if you're from IIM Ahmedabad, most people are very employable, they are much in demand, and I think at least for alumni, they should live the life they want sooner or later. Yeah, so I feel like I'm 44 now, so by the time I reach 40, I think everyone should really evaluate what are they doing and is that what they want to do.
So sprawling across various genres and mediums, how did you use your management skills to ideate art and target entertainment industries?
Yeah, so I often call myself an entrepreneur, which is an entrepreneur and author, because I have started with books in the field of entertainment, but I've extended to many things like films, like television, like giving talks, like writing articles and papers. And I have tried to use the principles I've learned at IIM in terms of diversification, in terms of brand diversification, in terms of creating a brand. Some people say now Chetan Bhagat is a brand. So I think all the brand management or the brand knowledge I had, I've learned in my marketing courses here. In fact, I did very well in marketing. I was the topper in marketing here, and a lot of people used to say that you have very unconventional ideas of marketing. So I never knew that I'll be using it, and I never knew that I'll be using it to market myself. But definitely, I think whatever I've learned here has helped me build the brand, because a lot of people credit me for my marketing. So I think the marketing aspect, and of course the diversification and managing the whole different aspects of my work, which typically authors don't do, they'll do just one thing, is something I've learned from my own life.
So what does this award mean to you?
Oh, it means a lot. I mean, I don't really go for many places to collect an award or something, but I'll go to the very, very special ones. And I think IIM Ahmedabad's award is very special. I've come here with my whole family, extended family, collect the award with my in-laws and mother, and there are 7 of us who have come. So obviously it means a lot to me. It means a lot to me because A, it is my college. But more importantly, even if it's not my college, it's IIM Ahmedabad. I mean, it's one of the best colleges in the country, and the alumni of this college is who's who of top Indian society, And for them to choose you as an outstanding alumnus, the entire alumnus is outstanding of this college. So to be outstanding in outstanding, I'm very lucky. I'm very lucky there's a category for arts and entertainment, because the competition is a little bit less there. Because other categories, finance, entrepreneurship, we have like big founders of companies and CEOs and CFOs and all these CXOs, which I am not clearly.
Can you relate some of the anecdotes from the time when you were here on campus, something you can recall?
Well, people have seen the movie and read the book, so there are tons of anecdotes about this place. But, you know, I always used to get in trouble. There was this thing, I think it's still there, class participation. And I love talking. So I would talk too much and I would do too much class participation. And then the teacher would scold me also a lot of times. And what I used to say, sometimes I would say things that didn't make any sense to people. And I would get into trouble a lot. So I remember that.
Gradually, creativity is becoming a bigger part of even the corporate world.
Yeah.
So where do you see IIMA playing a role there? And where do you see, in fact, how do we groom students to be creative and not straitjacket them into just thinking about numbers?
Yeah, I think the true leaders, I feel, and I'm not just talking about myself, I go to a lot of corporate conferences, I see inspiring leaders, inspiring CEOs. Those are people who balance the quant or the quantitative or the numbers, as you say, with the creative aspects, with the human aspects of business, with the innovative aspects of business. Today, like so much information, so much knowledge is already available on the internet. We are seeing the rise of artificial intelligence. A lot of processes are getting automated. So what is going to be the edge? The edge is going to be creativity and innovation. We still don't have a computer anywhere close to who can be creative. We can't automate creativity, we can't automate innovation. That has to come from human beings yet. And I think that applies in every field. It's not just in books or movies, it applies in any company also. So I think creativity and innovation is needed everywhere, even in politics. I mean, you have political leaders who come up with interesting ideas, slogans, schemes and social media campaigns. All these things are part of innovation. So they have to be there for people to survive today. So I think nobody should say that I'm a finance guy or I work in a bank. Why do I have to be creative? You have to be creative, otherwise you'll get obsolete.
Thank you so much for your time, Chetan. That was really amazing.
Thank you.